Hey viewers, welcome to episode 2 of my MATLAB programming course. This is kind of to get you used to the first simple commands of MATLAB. They are very useful commands, but they are kind of semi-randomly picked. They're not completely random. They are some of the most useful commands for, beginning programmers, but for experienced programmers, you will be like, why are you explaining this first? But for new programmers or new people to this program, they are very useful, or they can be very useful. First of all, we're going to start off with three commands that should be in most of your programs right in the top. They are to clear everything. CLC will clear your command window, clear will clear your workspace, and close all will clear out all of your figures. So I will give an example of that. If I had some data here, you can see that it also fills up the workspace. So we can make some other crap as well. So we have some stuff here now, we have some stuff here, and we can open a figure. And if we now run these commands, so first of all, we're going to do CLC. I'm going to demonstrate them in the command window. They will work exactly the same in the mat file, MATLAB file. So CLC cleaned out the command window. Then clear will clean out the workspace, and close all will clear out the figure. It's really easy to have, or really good to have all three of them, because removing all this clutter would be very good for your, well, readability of your errors and things like that. So anyhow, that being said, we can step through these. As you can see, I can now run lines one by one. I will explain that next episode when I discuss debugging. It's also why this red dot is here. Then we're going to implement variables, basically. We're going to say A is this and B is this. And as you can see, this is a horizontal vector. This is a vertical vector, however you want to call them. The difference is these semicolons that are there. And then we can multiply them, A times B or B times A, and obviously you get a 1x1 matrix or 3x3 matrix, depending on how you multiply them. And then we can display them. We already saw the display commands in the previous one. And note that here it says A is 1, 2, 3, B is blah, 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 and so on. But if you use disp, it doesn't say what you're displaying, so that can be very annoying. In fact, I find that very annoying. So I would rather have it like this, where it just says A is 1, 2, 3, because I can read that better. The problem is, the program will actually give you an error. Terminate statement with semicolon. So if you want to prevent this error, you need to put a semicolon behind the line where you see the error. And it will disappear, but it will no longer display on your workspace. Normally, you don't want things on your workspace, so keep that in mind. It slows down your program, plus it makes a lot of clutter here, and you don't want that, unless there's a specific reason for doing so. And then you're better off with fprintf, which we will see in a moment. So pause. Pause does exactly what it's supposed to do. As you can see, once I run it, the arrow disappears. And here it says paused, press any key. So to get rid of this, you have to be in the command window or in a figure, and then you can press any key. And then it runs true. Then you have a second type of pause, and we will run through those all at the same time until we reach this one. And you will see that it will print 1. Then it will pause for half a second, it will print 2, pause for half a second, 3, half a second, blah, 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 until it reaches 6, and then it will pause again, and it will ask me to hit a key. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are reasons to do this, to actually build a pause into your system, especially if you're working with machinery. So if you're linking this up to a robot, for example, you want to wait for a while until you're sure it has done its command. And if you don't know how to get feedback, or you can't get feedback because that's how your robot works. So if it doesn't give you feedback, you want to build in a pause to make sure the program doesn't send the next command until the first command is actually done. Obviously, this is in seconds, so not in milliseconds like in many programming languages. And we are now at the pause, so we are going to get rid of this pause. And then, well, it did everything for the rest in one go because I didn't have any breakpoints anymore. But as you can see here, it says the first element of A is. So I made an A matrix, which was 1, 2, 3. Obviously, the first element is 1. So display A1 should result in 1, and it did that. So after the 6 comes this one. And yeah, that of course is no good. If I want to see the first element of A is, I can't do it with a comment. Comments are made by percentage signs. You can do as many as you want, so you can also do multiples. This is a comment. There you go. You can do multiples. As long as you do one, it's okay. Don't do two, because then you get this, which will be explained in one of the next sections as well. Not the next one, but like number 4 or 5, I don't know. It is cell mode, so if you want to look that up, that's fine too. Otherwise, just follow the series and we will discuss that. So we have then fprintf, which, as I said, is kind of a more useful function than disp. Disp is for displaying one variable if you want that, but normally you would want, if you want feedback, you want detailed feedback. So you want to put a comment in there yourself. So this one states the first element of A is, and then it says integer. The percentage I means integer, and the slash n means go to the next line. And then what do I fill in for this integer? I fill in A1. So if you want to know how this works exactly, you have 4 ways to do that. First of all, you can just go stand on this, hit F1, and then it will open up the help window. Not sure if you can see this. Yeah, you can. Okay, cool. So it will open up the help window. It will say fprintf has, 2 ways to do it. It's file ID or format and blah, blah, blah. These are all the help files. They're very detailed. If you don't like this, so if you don't think, well, I need examples, then just go to Google, search it there. As long as you have the name, you should be fine. The second way to do this is, as I said, there are 4 ways outside of Google, that is. You can just do help and then fprintf. Then it will display the entire help file on the command window. In this case, I have a very small command window because I like to keep my editor as big as possible while still being able to see something of the command window. But yeah, you can obviously shift that a little bit and then you can read it easily. So help is the second way to do this. Then the third way to do this is to just type doc, which is also referenced here. But if you do doc fprintf, you can do this for every command, obviously. As you can see, it just gives you the same help file, but now in a separate window, which means that you can actually read it much, much easier. And it does have examples in there. So if you want to have certain examples, they are in here. It is just that not everything is in here. So yeah, use it at will. And the last way, which is kind of a difficult way to do it if you already know the command, it's look for. But if I want to look for something, I normally don't know what it is. So I know I want to do something with print, but I forgot what actually the name of the command was. And it will just give you everything that has print in either the title or the document. So this is going to be a long list. If you found your the one you're looking for, just hit Control C. It will disrupt the execution. Also, if you're running a program and you run into an infinite loop or something like that, or it's just taking too long, Control C while in the command window will break everything. So in this case, I don't know if it will actually come out, but I'm pretty sure it will eventually. It just takes a while. If I control C, as you can see, it immediately goes to the normal state, and I can continue on. So four ways to do that: F1, help, dock, and look for. Everything has their own uses, and basically use whatever you want. So we're going back to the a little bit higher because, well, we were here. The first element of A is 1. That's how it printed out, and that is exactly what we want. If we want to have feedback from our program, like there's an error at some point, or you want to see whether or not it completed an operation, you want to have not only like a 1, you want to have the operation has been completed, for example. You can do that with display, obviously, but if you want to include values in there, you want to do it like this. So you can take one of your variables, put it in here. Obviously, you can do multiples. So if I want to have, this last one says F is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It looks like this. So it is a 3x3 matrix. These semicolons make for the next line. And if I now wanted to make the fourth element of F is this, and the third, the fifth element, I don't know. The fifth element of F is, and then I can just do F5. So as you can see, you can do multiple things in one fprintf function. So the slash n will make it go to the next line, so they will be printed underneath each other. F9 puts it on the left side. We'll print F again because it's F9 will give you the opportunity to select something and put it in the command window without having to run your program. So F is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the surprising thing is the fourth element is not 4. The fourth element is 2. So keep that in mind if you want to work with matrices. This is not the way to do it. You don't go F4 because, you don't know how it would, or, well, you do know it now, but you can mess that up. The better way to do this is to say, I want F row 1, column 2. That's 2. So as you can see, it works with rows and columns as well, but you can also just do the fourth element. Just make sure you get the right element, the one that you want. So the fifth element is 5, so obviously it's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's kind of obvious, but you can see it printed the two lines underneath each other, so that you can make a whole list if you want to, and you can all put it in the same fprintf function. So that's about all I wanted to say for today. I think that's quite enough. I think you had enough information for one episode. Hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time.